When it comes to small boats, Switzer's a big deal, with 590 workers operating 100 vessels across 17 Aussie ports, completing more than 50,000 tug movements a year. What? That's what they're called. But right now, they're at war with the Maritime Union of Australia. The two sides have spent 3 years tussling over a new pay deal to no avail.
We have sat down for more than 75 times. We had face-to-face discussions and tried to work this one out.
They want to have the workforce succumb to what's been a very clear process of bullying and harassment over 4 years.
The union's expressed increasing irritation via strike action. That has led Switzer to lash out with an indefinite lockout from tomorrow.
It was a very difficult decision. It was the only option available to us. We've had about 1,000 incidents of industrial action that we have to deal with.
They've grown lazy and arrogant, and they think now that it's totally okay to hold Australia to ransom.
That escalation's a problem for all of us. Switzer's tugs, seen here chucking doughies in the Brisbane River for some reason, are basically the only game in town, which means if they stop, everything stops.
The nationwide threat to the economy is coming from a reckless employer.
We're going to have severe impacts for our importers and exporters.
Then hits the truck drivers and rail workers who transport goods. It then hits people in the logistics and warehousing sector and finds its way as a problem all the way to empty supermarket shelves.
The Fair Work Commission, which has the power to cancel the lockout and send both sides to arbitration, couldn't reach a resolution today. Retailers desperate for a better result tomorrow.
Christmas trading is a time when many retailers, including small businesses, make up to 2/3 of their profits for the year. So it could have a really catastrophic impact on supply chains across the country.
So could this tug of war cripple commerce and cancel Christmas?
It's amazing when you stop and think about it. Tugboats are really like the little engine that could.
Mm.
You don't realise how much of the heavy lifting that they do, no pun intended, of making sure that we have everything that we need at all times. But the idea that tugboats are going to steal Christmas is just going to ruin every bedtime story we'll ever read.
Yeah, they're meant to be cute.
That's right.
And have like a funny noise or something.
But this is the problem. I feel like that then affects the unions and their negotiating power, because the kind of imagery around the thing they're negotiating with is too cute.
So
and associated
cute.
With, like, Popeye, who is strong. You have to give him that. But he's still a little cartoon. I think they need to change the boats to make them more pointy and scary.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think Tugboat is too cute of a name.
Yeah. Yes.
I've got some new names. Do you want to hear my
new
names?
Yeah, OK, here we go.
Yanking Yachts.
Yep.
No, Waleed hates
it. No, yacht just seemed a bit aspirational.
Yeah, totally. But, yeah, make it kind of sexy.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Grabby Gondolas.
Grabby gondolas.
That's but gondolas.
Yeah. Oh, is that... Now I'm realising that's not how you pronounce it.
Okay.
And this one is my biggest swing. They could rebrand based on RuPaul's Drag Race. They could call themselves We Haul and Drag Place.
Right.
We are the Haul and Drag Place.
I think I'm... Grabby gondolas works.
Don't dot-com that just yet, you know?
Okay. All right, maybe I shouldn't work for the union movement.